And so we've reached the final of the World Cup, and it's been a long and fun journey.
Yeah.
Entertaining too, because first we had this really fun group stage, and then we had this completely topsy-turvy semi-final, which none of us expected.
And we had a lot of rain. A
lot of rain, two brilliant runouts and all that. But yeah, so finally we're here in the last episode that we will have for the World Cup at SportsRoom. This is Reuben Joe, and with me here is Anirudh Madhavan. And what was that semi-final like? Some phenomenal swing bowling,
yeah.
And two former captains whose runouts changed the match for their teams.
So like we mentioned in the previous episode, that New Zealand has been that one team which can expose the Indian batting
exactly.
side. Which happened again. Happened in the warm-up match.
Yeah.
So,
and
happened again.
We took them lightly again this time. I mean, we didn't get to play that match against them in the group stage.
Huh.
But then
probably would have lost that.
Probably would have lost that. But yeah, it was... What went wrong for India again? Because we clearly looked like the best type, one of the best teams in the tournament. Maybe
yeah.
England was the other one. And then we had this top order just collapse just like
Which
that.
Which happens, like, it is bound to happen. You know, even with the perfect team, once in 2 years,
yeah.
it will happen. Eventually, it did happen. But
and it had to happen in a knockout match.
Yeah. So, as the people are arguing whether we should have the playoffs.
Yeah, even Kohli said that, right?
Yeah.
Yeah. Kohli said that. He said he wants the IPL-style thing in the World Cup. Anyway, so, but then again, we spoke about the middle order. But then again, they were sort of exposed because
yeah.
even though there was only so much like the late middle order, like Jadeja could
play. Number 8 was the one saving.
Yeah, but the middle order was again exposed.
Yeah.
But it's India's old enemy again, once again. You know, the swing and the seam, something that we've always had a problem with since ages.
That is the main point why Rohit Sharma is not as good as he is in ODI, as he is in Test match.
Yes.
So.
Mm. But what do you say about this trio, Bolt, Matt Henry and Ferguson? Because they are going to be crucial again for New Zealand in the final.
Depends on the mindset, I would think. So, if they get early wickets, I don't know how England will react. They should react by attacking.
Mm.
Because they have batting till number 9 or 10.
Yeah.
Yeah, especially Plumpitt's there. So,
yeah.
If they go on the defensive after losing a couple of quick wickets, then it's like quicksand. They'll keep getting in. So.
Mm. Yeah. So, the other semi-final that we had, and again, another unexpected result, at least the scale of the victory, margin of victory, because England just...
Destroyed
Australia, and it's mostly like riding on that home support that they have. You know, these football football fans all over
it's
the stadium.
Probably
chanting.
Only because it was Australia, and they have the Ashes coming up. And most cricket fans in England.
And they were singing, "It's coming home, cricket is coming home."
It's already home.
but yeah, that was also even you know Jason Roy, the kind of form that he's in.
He's been the most crucial player. He goes out to the team and
they lose matches.
He was brought in for the India game even though he wasn't 100% because they knew he was crucial and he delivered. So, and the opening partnership has been phenomenal.
Yeah.
So.
Like for all the batting depth that they have, it's just like they just needed 4 batsmen to destroy Australia. They
if you have someone like Josh Butler coming in at number 6, he would make the top 3 in any other team.
And even though Mitchell Stark did break the record for most number of wickets, he was helpless at. He got that LBW and all that. But then besides that, there's only so much he could do in this match. And so that was the two semi-finals that we had. Really good ones. And you know, the big game at Lords. Obviously, this is a big, big deal for New Zealand that they are reaching a consecutive World Cup final.
Yeah.
And also, again, they are against the world's best.
Mm.
Arguably the world's best team. Strongest team. So, it's easy to say that England can win this. There are a lot of ways they can probably destroy New Zealand. But where are the ways in which New Zealand, the underdog in this match, could defeat England?
Go for rain.
Oh.
And so, it aids swing and get Bolt and Henry to, you know, like you said earlier, get 2 or 3 wickets
even
the power play.
Yeah.
And see how England react to that.
Mm-hmm.
Because batting-wise, unless Guptill starts firing again, he was the top scorer in the last World Cup.
Yeah.
So unless they do an England and start off the power play, they bat first.
Mm-hmm.
Again, toss is going to be crucial.
Who's gonna, I mean, what are they? What
it's
are
traditionally
teams?
Been the person winning the toss batting first. And
batting
it will be the same.
Yeah.
I don't know don't expect a change in the last game. So,
so the team batting first has the upper hand.
Has the advantage. We have, we've had four games of loss this time in this tournament, and all four have been won by the team batting first.
Batting first. Okay. And so the chasing team, is the difficult.
Chasing is difficult. I think twice or thrice the team chasing has been bowled out.
Okay. Okay.
So it's a huge advantage in terms of the toss.
And well, as good as New Zealand are, they have this big problem with the top two really not. Because there's so much relying on Williamson.
He scored even, almost one third of the team's runs.
Yeah, one third of the team's runs, and even Taylor after that. Then you see the all-rounders like Jimmy Neesham and Dave Grandhomme and all chipping in some way. But the top two really need to come.
Really need to.
Fire and load.
So again, what I was saying about Kapil, same applies. They've had really bad luck with the opening partnership, as in with Kapil. They had Munro who failed, then he got injured or left out. Nichols comes in, he doesn't fire, so it doesn't happen very often that two of both of them don't fire.
Yeah.
So this is the best stage for them to do so.
This is the middle order India wish they had. But yeah, anyway, so as the figures stand right now, among the batsmen who remain, Root is the top now with 549, and Williamson has 548. Both of them could, if they have a century each, they could
go past
Rohit Sharma. But then, okay, Root is there and there are batsmen around him and all. But then, when it comes to bowling for England, it's interesting to see how, even though Archer and Wood have the most wickets, it's interesting how Wokes comes in. And
Wokes has been the game changer in a couple of games.
Yeah.
Very crucial wickets. Really good at the beginning of the innings. Much like Bolt, not at that level, but he'll give you the wickets and
crucial wickets.
They have an all-round bowling unit. Even Adil Rashid last game, though the spinners haven't been doing well throughout the tournament, but Owen Morgan has always backed him, and last game he got three wickets. Turned out to be crucial.
That's one point. Another thing, I mean, we expected this, but as it stands, the top 15 bowlers right now are all fast bowlers. So spinners. It's in England after all, so they.
It's not a pitch where you like. A lot of people have been asking why Ishobhi isn't being played, but they're not the type of pitches. One or two pitches where she should have played, like Pakistan game.
Yeah.
But I don't see him. I don't see them playing two spinners, and if they have to play one spinner, they're not going to chuck out Santner, who's also helpful with the bat.
And Williamson was also there to pitch in. They really need a spinner, but so. We have Wokes, the silent killer in the English side. And then the other side, we also have, though there is Ferguson and Bolt with 18 and 17 wickets each, we have the other silent killer, Matt Henry, as we saw in the semi-final. That was also...
He's not rated that highly. Exactly. And he's not the player who people like are afraid of. But they only focus on Bolt mostly and then Ferguson because of this tournament. But he's been going about his business and he's been aiding Bolt in that opening spell, and he's the one who damaged India more than Bolt. He took three wickets, three important wickets. So all of them are good given the conditions. So
So that's there. And so what's your prediction? The final?
England
by any huge victory or
whoever bats first. If New Zealand bat first, I don't see them going past 350.
Okay.
And I would back this England team to get that score. If England bat first and are as aggressive as they usually are, they will go past 300 at least. And then scoreboard pressure, chasing, final, that all comes in.
So that's the World Cup final that they're finally going to have now. And both teams, as we know, both teams could become first-time champions. And so will it be Owen Morgan or will it be Kane Williamson who will return as national heroes? So that's, well...
Morgan has to return to Ireland as a national hero.
That's funny how it works. So anyway, that is the World Cup final that we have, and it's going to be a big, big match, and we're sure you'll be watching it too. Anyway, so thank you so much for joining us, and don't forget to check out all our other content that we have, our videos, our features, and everything that we have on the website, as well as in the magazine. We are also coming up with some great stories, and we have our Deputy Chief of Bureau, Anirudh Bhatia from Delhi, who's also writing stories for us. So thank you so much for joining us, and hope you have a great time.